It's a crime that can't go unnoticed, and it makes the city look trashy.
As trash from illegal dumping piles up, so does the effort to try to stop it. Only at 41 Action News, Ariel Rothfield rode along with the investigator trying to figure this out. Ariel?
Well, Mike, there are signs posted all around the city warning if you dump your trash on the side of the road, you will face a fine. But tonight, we discovered many people are not following the law, and there are only two inspectors for the entire city cracking down on this crime.
Whether it's trash toys, couches, or clothes dumped on the side of the road.
Got a good look at the plate.
Alan Ashurt does not mess around.
Legal dumping is a crime just like any other crime.
He's one of two Kansas City investigators tasked with looking for signs of illegal dumping.
Nothing here, nothing there. Now we got a tire.
And catching the people behind it. Tonight, we're riding along with him to find some of the worst illegal dumping sites in the city.
I go through these dump sites 2-3 times a day.
Our first stop, we find shingles, nails, bags of clothes, bottles, and broken glass. It's an area with few homes around, so Ashurt relies on his hidden cameras to catch dumpsters in the act.
This is a fun little file, and I run across these folks. I mean, look at that truck.
Cameras have helped cut down on dumping in small sites across the city, but in certain areas, Ashurt admits it's a challenge.
One of the problems that we have is a stretch of road, you know, that's a half mile, 3/4 miles long.
Which is where we meet Curtis Foster.
Ridiculous, what it is.
Who's lived near Snybar Road his entire life, another hot spot for illegal dumping.
I see it every day, damn near. People go by dumping.
He and his neighbors have tried to post signs, even mow the land across the street.
I just try to make it look good because I don't want somebody to just start dumping crap.
But it doesn't always work, and that's where Ashurt comes in.
I'm extremely happy to see this.
Persistent and determined to stop garbage like this from piling up.
I've probably written 600, 650, 700 tickets. So two repeat offenders in that time. So it's working. It's like you just got to catch them. It hits them right where it hurts, you know, in the pocketbook.
Now, if you are caught illegally dumping, you could face up to a $1,000 fine or 1 year in jail. If you catch anyone in the act or see any spots in your neighborhood you're concerned about, you're asked to call 311. Live in studio, Ariel Rothfield, 41 Action News.